But I do think it's important for people to hear from you personally, for you to address it. I know that you've released a statement because you decided to take your name off the documentary involving Russell Simmons and his alleged abuse of women. And I think people question, why would Oprah, of all people, do that?
Well, first of all, I just want to say that I have lived Me Too since I was 9 years old and was raped at nine, sexually assaulted from 9 to 14, and then raped again at 14. And nothing is harder than standing up for yourself when you're 14 and not being believed. And I was not believed by my own family. So I stand in support of these women. I believe them. It was a hard decision because I knew that Russell Simmons had started publicly pressuring me and that me pulling out of the documentary was going to look like I was being pressured.
So what do you
say publicly and privately pressured.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. And so what do I say to that is, for me, and Gail knows this, in all experiences of my life, and particularly when I'm in a crisis, the only question for me is what is the right thing to do?
For
and
you.
For me. Yeah. And so before the public pressure had started, before Russell had gone with his Instagram, I had gone to the filmmakers and I had said to them, Houston, I think we have a problem here because new information had come forward the very first time this was announced. Yeah. And I said, I think we need to pull out of Sundance. And if we can't pull out of Sundance, I'm going to have to take my name off. I don't want to have to take my name off because it's going to be a big hullabaloo.
But you said pull out of Sundance so we can get it right.
Yeah, pull out of Sundance because I don't care about awards. I don't care. I just care about getting it right. And I think there's some inconsistencies in the stories that we need to look at.
Russell Simmons has first of all, he's denied all of the allegations vigorously.
Yeah.
You, again, have said that you unequivocally support these women.
Yes.
Why are you making it a point to say that, even though you're withdrawing from the...
Because I believe that the women's voices deserve to be heard. And as an executive producer, I also was in a position where I thought some things were not right. I wanted the context of the story to be broadened. I wanted more women brought into the story. And I will say this, that I thought Michelle Miller's story last week with three of the women, one of the women had just been added, Alexia Norton Strong, I think is her name. And I had asked that more women be added. When you see the documentary, which I do hope people will see the documentary, I felt that story needed to be broadened. One of the things I said to the producers is, I don't think that deserves to just be a soundbite. And I can honestly say that I learned more about Alexia Norton Strong in Michelle Miller's story than I did in the doc. So I was asking for changes. And let me just say this. I've been an executive producer since the beginning of The Oprah Show. And there were many times when, you know, people are saying, what's the timeline? Until the thing is on the screen, you have the right to change your mind and make changes. And I remember many times on the show, particularly there was a Columbine story we were going to run for the 10th anniversary. And the night before, I pulled it because something about it didn't feel right. And I thought, we are going to cause more school shootings if we put this on the air. So I've always been in the position as an executive producer, if I say I want changes, usually those are done. So what this has taught me is don't put your name on anything that you do not have creative control over.
But some people have perceived this as a victory for Russell.
Yeah.
And Russell.
This is not a victory for Russell. And I unequivocally say that I did not pull out because of Russell. This is not a victory lap for him. I cannot be silenced by a Russell Simmons after all I've been through. And also, you know, I spent 3 years on trial trying to protect the girls at my school who had accused a dorm parent of sexual assault. 3 years on trial and nobody believed them.
But Oprah, it struck me as odd that someone would accuse you of not standing up for women and black women in particular.
I know. It's ridiculous. To me, that is ridiculous and also ridiculous to think that I could be intimidated by Russell Simmons. Yeah.
Okay. Oprah claims that while she still supports the women who accused Russell Simmons of sexual assault, she pulled out of the documentary because of inconsistencies in one of the women's story. Question, fam. So Leaving Neverland, the Michael Jackson documentary, didn't have inconsistencies. I don't believe her. And I don't believe Gayle King. You know why? Because they're white supremacists. You don't have to be white to be a white supremacist. All you have to do is think like them. All you have to do is carry out their bidding. Oprah Winfrey pranced around America as Michael Jackson's friend when he was alive. All at his ranch, riding around on the golf cart, all in the man's house, hanging out with his family members. The moment he dies, man's body ain't even cold. She taking a dump on him, dragging his name through the mud, helping to destroy his legacy. Threw the man under the bus. Gave his lying accusers a platform to help destroy his legacy. Doing the same thing to Russell Simmons, who she claimed as a friend. Now she's dragging Russell, trying to help destroy another black man's legacy. I don't believe that she just dropped out of the documentary because of inconsistencies in the story. I believe that she buckled under the collective pressure from the public. I think that when 50 went after her, that was a big deal, and it brought a lot of attention to her bias against black men. I support victims of sexual assault and rape. I'm inclined to believe them, but I'm going to need some proof before I set out to destroy someone's legacy or assassinate their character. If a friend of mine and I fall out and the relationship ends, it ends right there. I'm not throwing any secrets out there, and I'm not going to help someone else bring them down. I'm not built like that, regardless of my so-called role in the media. Paul Mooney tried to warn us back in the Gap about Oprah Winfrey. He told us about Mammy Oprah. We didn't want to believe him. Yet, here we are. I would not want to be friends with Oprah Winfrey to save my life. With friends like those, you don't need enemies. Tyler Perry, watch your back. You're next. No more talk.